We shall start by now. Assalamu alaikum everyone, this is Dr. Asma here. I extend my warm welcome to all the viewers of my today's live webinar to by FUMU. I'm glad that the FUMU has taken yet another initiative to conduct the series of webinars during this pandemic, continuing the education through virtual learning. This pandemic has indeed shocked us, shredded us, and distorted us from our goals. But FUMU was trying, and in fact is still trying, to streamline and to be focused. आज का जो हमारा सेमिनार है, the webinar है, थोड़ा सा different है. Here are the speakers are the young undergraduates of our Unani system. In fact, undergraduate students of our Unani system. From various colleges, that's Government Unani, Government Nizamia Tibia College, Charminar, Hyderabad, Abdul Haq Unani Medical College, Karnool, and the relocated students of Al Arif Unani Medical College. It is an attempt by FUMU to build up the confidence in our young speakers and to lay them the platform to showcase their capabilities, to add the color and shine to this webinar. Our chief guest, Ms. Saida Falak, with a bright and inspirational background, has joined us today. I welcome Ms. Saida Falak. She's an international karate champion. She's a golden girl of Hyderabad. She's a winner of 22 international karate championship and 20 national karate championship. She's the first Telanganite to have been qualified to represent India at the World and Asian Karate Championship, as well as the first Telanganite to win the senior national title. She is the gold medal winner of USA Open Karate Championship 2016, held in Las Vegas, USA. She has also represented India at many Premier Leagues and series. I welcome you again, Falak, and thanks for sharing your time with a few more. Our today's host is Mrs. Afifa Wasif. So she's the host and she'll be coordinating the whole session. So over to you, Dr. Afifa.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, you can carry on.
Assalamu alaikum. मैं अफीफा तस्कीन फेमिनिन यूनानी मेडिकल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन की जानिब से आज के इस वेबिनार में आप सबका खैर मकदम करती हूँ। मैं बिना किसी तमहीद के मिस सैयदा फलक इंटरनेशनल कराटे चैंपियन से अदबन गुजारिश करती हूँ कि वो अपने कीमती अल्फाज से हमें मुस्तफीद फरमाए। मिस सैयदा फलक,
इस फलक जस्ट होल्ड ऑन एज फार एज आई नो या ये सैयदा फलक या हेलो आर यू देयर नहीं नहीं यू जस्ट अनम्यूट देयर
Assalamu alaikum and good afternoon everyone. I hope you all are doing good. I'm very glad to join this webinar with you all today. So Unani system of medicine has tremendous potential and its contribution towards management of COVID, right from precaution to management of the disease and the concept of immunomodulators and the strengthening of immune system is the need of the hour. I'm glad to be associated with FUMU. May you reach great height of success. Ameen, inshallah. And a very happy Independence Day to all of you. Thank you.
Now, we shall start with our the main session. Okay, that's the paper presentation by our four undergraduate students. Okay, Afifa, over to you. You can carry on. Thank you, Ms. Falak. Thank you so much for sharing this time with us. Nice to see you.
You're welcome.
Yes, Afifa, proceed. Afifa, are you there?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
We'll start with your, coordinating the whole event, Afifa. I think there's some network problem on your side. So, where is Arshia? Arshia. Arshia Anjum from third year.
Assalamu alaikum, ma'am. Yes.
Yeah, Arshia, I think there's a network problem on the Afifa side. I think you are the first presentee, right?
Yeah, ma'am.
Yeah, you can start sharing your screen and you can proceed with your paper, please.
Okay, ma'am.
Arshia, wait. वुमेन इन मेडिसिन हिस्टोरिकल पर्सपेक्टिव एंड रीसेंट ट्रेंड्स के उन्वान पर रोशनी डालने के लिए मिस अर्शिया अंजुम स्टूडेंट ऑफ बीओएमएस थर्ड ईयर गवर्नमेंट निजामिया टीपी कॉलेज रिलोकेटेड फ्रॉम अलारी फ्यूनानी मेडिकल कॉलेज से गुजारिश करती हूँ कि वे अपने ख्यालात का इजहार करें.
Today's my topic is historical perspective. Am I audible?
Yeah, but be a bit louder, Arshia.
Okay. Over the recent years, we have been seeing that there is an increased discussion of feminization of the medical workforce. It is a realization that medicine is a human experience that is in the heart of the society. One of the main theme of this presentation, which magnifies the attitude towards women in medicine. The general treatises mainly studied head to toe in illness in an encyclopedic manner and then offered some remedies. History of women in medicine. Women's role in medicine and healing is evident throughout the history from ancient world to the present days. During the period of witch hunting, midwifery was the only profession in which women were allowed to practice. Partly because its lower status did not attract male medical practitioners, the introduction of obstetric forceps, however, encouraged men into this field of healthcare. There were only general writings to women's illness. There were no medical specialization which considered a modern medicine feature. General medical writings are those treatises such as Zubdat al-Khawani, selection of rules which have not elaborately discussed illness. Women in medicine in medieval Islamic world. Women in this era was regularly involved in medical practice in some capacity. One of the pioneering women in this Islamic world was Hazrat Rufaida al-Islamiyya radiyallahu ta'ala anha in the 7th century AD, amongst the first people to accept Islam. She was the first Muslim nurse and a good social worker, very kind, devoted, committed, patient. She, along with other nurses, served to injured soldiers in the Battle of Badr, Uhud, Khandaq, Khaybar. She focused on hygiene and stabilizing the patient. Women in medicine in 19th century. Some women went to great lengths to conceal their identity. Scientific discovery of new laboratory techniques during the 19th century brought about era of modern medicine, which was characterized by professionalization and continued. The Medical Registration Act introduced in 1858 did not exclude women. The first woman officially registered by General Medical Council was Dr. Elizabeth Blackwell in the year 1858. In India, only after 1880, the entry of women in medical profession took place. The first Indian physician was Dr. Anandi Gopal Joshi. Women in medicine in 20th century. The establishment of the first medical schools led to an increase in number of women practicing medicine in early 20th century. The period of 1988 to 97 registered as a rapid increase of women doctors. In recent years, the medical profession has undergone major changes in both scientific and human terms. These changes have all contributed to the growing number of women entering profession. Today's medical workforce. Over the past four decades, the proportion of women entering medical schools have increased rapidly. The female medical students now outnumber male. The female wing has been started with a vision to enlighten the work of Unani females, to bring out the ruling quality of every woman, which is hidden behind curtains of various hurdles. To bring them all under one umbrella to flourish in their practice and research and give them an opportunity to put their efforts together towards the upliftment of our system and to represent their works without any restriction. So it's well said that teamwork makes the dream work. Areas of timely development. Further research is needed to explore the cost effectiveness of the existing and future inventions in this field. Growing points. Work planners, policymakers, and colleges should continue to develop interventions that may reduce disparities in career choices, as well as considering ways to increase participation and activity. Specialty choices. More women doctors appear to choose what have been termed people-oriented specialties, such as pediatrics and psychiatry. The specialties with the highest proportion of male registrars include public health medicine, obstetrics, gynecology, pediatrics. So it is said that a woman is born to create, nurture, and transform. Conclusion. I finally conclude that this presentation was an historical perspective highlighting the role of women in medicine and more recent trends. Further work needs to be done to explore strategies that may maximize participation rates, particularly during child-rearing years, enable greater work-life balance for both men and women doctors. The reference of my presentation is taken from the following books: British Medical Bulletin, Zabdat al-Khawaneen, Jami al-Amraz, etc. Thank you.
Thank you, Aisha. The major health problem since pandemic is unwan par roshni dalne ke liye Miss Rukhsana Begum, final year student of Government Nizamia Tibbi College, se guzarish karti hu ke apne alfaz ke zariye hum sab ki malumat mein izafa kare. Miss Rukhsana Begum.
Yes, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. First of all, happy Independence Day to all of you. Myself, Rukhsana Begum, student of the UMS final year from Government Nizamia Tibbi College, Char Minar. And I'm very much thankful to SMA Ma'am for giving me the good opportunity to present a webinar. I congratulate the entire team of SMA and all the organizers of this webinar. Today my topic of webinar is the major health problem since independence. Am I audible, Afisa?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
Louder, Roxana.
This is because of the major health problem since independence. This is because of lack of appropriate infrastructure and equipment, lack of preventive care, delay in appropriate health care, leading to deaths that could have been prevented. Let's take introduction. Assessment of health status and health problems is the first required for any planned effort developed to healthcare services. The data required for the analysis of health situation and health problems comprises of mortality, morbidity, demographic condition, socioeconomic factors, etc. So in the history, India has been a continuous culture for 5,000 years. This means that even before the British and modern medicine, sciences entered the Indian medical science. India had a well-established medical system. Our history of established healthcare system is as old as the assimilation of Aryan culture. This was taken further with the advent of Mughals and the Yunani approach of medicine, and finally formalized by the French British. King Akbar was one of the few rulers who saw benefits in combining practices of both Ayurveda and Yunani medicine to develop a better healthcare system. Definition of health. According to WHO, health is a state of complete physical, mental, social, and spiritual well-being, and not merely the absence of disease or infirmity. Health problem. So, health problem, it is the state in which we are unable to function normally. So it is a state of illness or unhealthy. Factors that play important role in health problems: lack of awareness amongst people, shortage of trained medical and paramedic practitioners, lack of appropriate infrastructure and equipment, lack of preventive care, delay in appropriate health care leading to death that could have been prevented, as I told earlier. The rise of communicable diseases, especially those related to the lifestyle, lack of awareness and use of the insurances, either private or government. Major health problem. Major health problems includes communicable disease problem, nutritional problem, environmental sanitation problem, medical care problem, and the last, population problem. Communicable diseases caused by direct or indirect spread of pathogens from a person or thing to another. Communicable diseases in India are malaria, tuberculosis, diarrhea, acute respiratory infections, leprosy, AIDS, filaria, salivary meningitis, viral hepatitis, chickenpox, smallpox, etc. are among the other important communicable disease problems in India. So, malaria is also one of the communicable diseases which is caused by a parasite, female Anopheles mosquito. Cases has increased in Goa, Madhya Pradesh, Orissa. During the year 2005, there were 940 reported malaria deaths in India. Next, tuberculosis. Pulmonary tuberculosis is a contagious bacterial infection that involves the lungs, but they spread to another organ also. Tuberculosis is caused by mycobacterium tuberculosis. Next, diarrheal diseases. Diarrheal diseases is the second leading cause of death in children under 5 years of old. It is spread by bacterial, viral, parasitic organisms. Respiratory tract infections. Acute respiratory diseases is one of the major causes of mortality and morbidity in children. It is estimated that about 13.6% hospital admissions and 13% deaths in pediatric wards are due to acute respiratory infection. In acute respiratory infection, the diseases include tonsillitis, laryngitis, bronchitis, sinusitis, throat infection, pneumonia, etc. Next, leprosy. It is another major public health problem in India. It is caused by Mycobacterium leprae. During the year 2003 to 2004, total of 2.2 lakh new cases were detected. Leprosy is also known as Hansen's disease, and in a Yamanu bowel effect. Next, eight. Acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. The problem of AIDS is increasing in magnitude every year. It is estimated that by the end of year 2005, there were about 5 to 7 million HIV positive cases in country. Filariasis. Filariasis, commonly known as elephantiasis and lymphatic filariasis. It is caused by infection with parasite. The causative organism is Vicraria bancrofti. 90% cases of filariasis are due to Vicraria bancrofti. In communities where filariasis is transmitted, all age people are affected. Lymphatic filariasis affects over 120 million people in 72 countries throughout the tropics and subtropics of Asia, Africa, the Western Pacific and parts of the Caribbean and South America. And many more like Kalazar, meningitis, viral hepatitis, helminth are among the other communicable diseases in India. The next problem in the major health problem is nutritional problem. The specific nutritional problem in our country protein, energy, malnutrition, nutritional anemia, iron deficiency disorder, and low birth weight, xerothalmia. These all are included in nutritional problems. So first is protein, energy, malnutrition. Insufficiency of the so-called food gap appears to be the chief cause of protein energy malnutrition, which is a major health problem, particularly in the first year of life. Next is nutritional anemia. India has probably the highest prevalence of nutritional anemia in women, and young children are estimated to suffer from anemia. 60 to 80% of pregnant women are anemic, and the most 20 to 40% of maternal deaths are due to anemia. Next, low birth weight. This is the major public health problem in many developing countries. 30% of babies born are low birth weight as compared to about 4% in some developed countries. Xerothalmia. This is also called as nutritional blindness. It is due to vitamin A deficiency. Trypanosomiasis has been the major cause of nutritional blindness in children. Iron deficiency disorders. This is also one of the nutritional problem disorders in which goiter and other IDD has been known to highly endemic in sub-Himalaya region. And many more others like endemic fluorosis and lacerism in certain part of country. The next is environmental sanitation problem. It includes, the main problem is lack of safe water in many areas of the country, primitive methods of excreta disposal. Besides, this has been a growing concern about the impact of new problems resulting from population exclusion, urbanization, and industrialization, leading to hazards to human health in air, in water, and in food chain. Next is medical care problem. Inadequate financial sources, health benefits to the urban population, uneven distribution, migration to the urban health problem, have been aggravated like overcrowding in hospitals. in a report of staffing. Scarcity of certain drugs and medicine. So these all are the major health problems since independence, and many more other diseases. So during the shortage of time, I include only some of them.
So the question is, how can we help? By the proper vaccination, according to the age and schedule, and early diagnosis followed by the treatment, and improve nutrition day by day according to the age, and by the safer environment, we can help to the needy people. Lastly, I'm thankful to each and every one of you for listening my presentation. Thank you.
Thanks, Roxana. Medical guidance and teachings of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in fighting pandemics. इस मौजू पर लपकुशाई करने के लिए मैं मिस जहरा लतीफ, स्टूडेंट ऑफ बीओएमएस फाइनल ईयर, गवर्नमेंट निजामिया तिब्बी कॉलेज, रीलोकेटेड फ्रॉम अलारी फिनानी मेडिकल कॉलेज, से दरख्वास्त करती हूँ कि वो हम सबको अहम मालूमात से मुस्तफीद फरमाए। मिस जहरा लतीफ।
अस्सलाम वालेकुम एवरीवन, दिस इज जहरा लतीफ फ्रॉम बीओएमएस फाइनल ईयर, एंड टुडे माय टॉपिक इज अबाउट द गाइडेंस and the teaching of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in fighting the pandemic. Okay, let me start my topic. See, every morning when the clock works, we get two notifications. One about the local weather and next about the number of deaths because of COVID or any pandemic. The real tragedy in all this is that we are living in a time where checking number of deaths in pandemic is not different from checking weather. It is as common as checking the weather and checking number of deaths due to the pandemic. We get daily notifications. So on this, I want to say a few lines. Rahiye ab aisi jagah chalkar jahan koi na ho. Rahiye ab aisi jagah chalkar jahan koi na ho. Ham sukoon koi na ho aur ham zaban koi na ho. Bedard o diwar sa ek ghar banana chahiye. Bedard o diwar sa ek ghar banana chahiye. कोई हमसाया ना हो और पासबान कोई ना हो. पढ़े अगर बीमार तो कोई ना हो तीमारदार. पढ़े अगर बीमार तो कोई ना हो तीमारदार. और अगर मर जाए तो नोहा खवा कोई ना हो. सी दिस इज व्हाट आई वांट टू रिप्रेजेंट द होल टॉपिक ऑन इट. द इमर्ज ऑफ वायरस इज नॉट इन ह्यूमन हैंड्स. वी कैन नॉट कंट्रोल द इमर्ज ऑफ वायरस, बट द स्प्रेड ऑफ डिसीज इज श्योरली अंडर आवर कंट्रोल. Of course, in the year before the years of this, in the era of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Islam has maintained and controlled a town which is known as Taun-e-Amwas. See, by practicing the medical guidance and teaching of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they have maintained a very big town which is known as Taun-e-Amwas. So, my brothers and sisters in humanity, Allah obliges us to protect ourselves and also others. So let us remember a few words of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Those who are merciful will be shown mercy by the merciful God. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, those who are merciful will be shown mercy by the merciful God. So here I am going to show few of the things which we already know, just want to make a relapse of that. So you can know it once again. Few things. by which we can protect yourself and also others during the pandemic. That is the first point I want to say is don't add the panic. People are feared of because of this. And so I request to don't add the panic to the people. Don't share unverified videos and unverified information. And the second is prevent the spread. We can prevent the spread by practicing correct hand hygiene, ensure cough etiquette, avoiding touching your face, maintaining social distance and isolation. About social distance and isolation, our Rasul Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that do not place a sick person with a healthy person. It is a hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He states that do not put a sick person with a healthy person. In our current situation, social distancing and isolation has been frustratingly difficult task for the government to impose. But during the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, all the people used to follow the rule as a religious order. So it's our duty also to follow the rule as a religious or the rule of a community. Okay. And the next point what I want to discuss here is about hygiene. And here I'm going to relate it with the references and also the Islamic references of Quran and Hadith. See, hygiene is not only physical cleanness. Hygiene is not physical cleanness, but also spiritual purity. Hygiene, or not only the physical cleanness, but also the spiritual purity, has its own importance in Islam. A hadith says that, Bismillahirrahmanirrahim, At-tahurul shatrul iman. Cleanliness is half of the faith. And one more the saying of Quran is there. I want to read one ayat, Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ التَّوَّابِينَ وَيُحِبُّ الْمُتَّحَّرِينَ. Truly Allah loves those who turn unto Him in repentance and love those who purify themselves. This is the ayat from Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 222. The next point what I want to discuss here is seeking medical treatment. Seeking medical treatment. Islam, as taught by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is a practical and a progressive faith-based system. The Holy Prophet encouraged people to seek medical assistance alongside relying on the power of prayer. Because there is an ayat and also a hadith said by Bukhari, written in the Bukhari and narrated by Abu Huraira. That is, مَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ زَاءً إِلَّا أَنزَلَ لَهُ شِفَاءً. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, there is no disease that Allah has created except that He also has created its treatment. This is the hadith by Sahih Bukhari, hadith number 5678. So Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam advised the mankind and also other who did to have trust on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you take the treatment, have trust that He is the only one who is going to give shifa. One of the example with one of the story what I want to narrate here is, once a man was advised who did not tie his camel, and because he trust Allah. So Abu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that tie the camel, then trust Allah. So in the similar way, it's our duty to take the medicine and cure and trust Allah. The next I want to tell about quarantine and the travel ban, which was before, which we knew already from the Quran and Hadith 1400 years ago. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam preached the importance of travel bans and quarantine in places contaminated with diseases. So here also is a hadith I want to represent with you. This is the hadith about the plague, which narrated by Saud radhiyallahu ta'ala. The Prophet said, if you hear of an outbreak of plague in a land, do not enter it. But if the plague breaks out in a place while you are in, do not leave the place. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Ma yuskaru fi ta'amu. This is from Sahih Bukhari, hadith number 5728. Now the next is the free medical care. Free medical care and financial assistance during pandemic are crucial. During the time of Hazrat Umar رضي الله تعالى عنه, the Baitul Mal, the government treasury, were used to help the poor, needy, disabled, elderly, orphans, widow, and the persons who were suffering with this pandemic diseases. So it's the duty of our government also to provide these facilities so that people may not fear because of lack of crisis or because of lack of money. And now I would like to share some of the medicines which are also discussed, some of the food which act as the medicines which are discussed in Hadith and also in the Quran. The first one I want to say about is the fig, ficus. The common name is fig. This comes from the family of Moraceae. It has its medical use. It is said that it is mostly used to treat inflammation and cardiovascular diseases. It is also used in antiviral, as it is the mode of action of it is an antagonist. There it reduces the action of viruses and the bacteria. It works against the action of viruses and the bacteria. The second I want to talk about, which is also mentioned in the Quran, and the reference which I want to give from the fig, the reference is by the fig and the olive in the Surah 95, Surah Al-Teen. The next is Allium sativum, that is garlic. Garlic, the medical use of the garlic is so much. It is called as a treasurer for a poor man. It has a lot of effect and lot of uses. The first is it maintains the blood pressure. It means indirectly it helps the cardiovascular system also. It is used in the arthritis, muscle pain, and so many other diseases. And it also have long lasting medical uses. The next is the ginger officinalis, Gingiba officinalis, which is also called as ginger. The medical use of this is, it is used in the respiratory disorders, nausea, cardiovascular, and many other inflammations. The action of it is, the fresh ginger is very effective in human orthopneumonia virus. It induced plaque formation on airway epithelium by blocking viral attachment. It prevents from attaching the virus to the airway tract. The next I want to talk about is the date. Date palm, khajur, the Urdu name of it is khajur. This also have a very, very importance in the medical use. It is used as an diuretic, appetizer, digestive, anti-intoxicating medicine also. And the reference which is given for this is from the Surah. It is given from the Surah An-Nahl, the B, verse number 11. He caused to grow for you thereby the crops, olives, palm trees, grapevines, and from all the fruit, indeed, it is the sign of people who give thoughts. This is the surah, the ayat of Surah Al-Nahl. The next I want to tell about is one more hadith of Sahih Al-Bukhari 5680, in which he says that there is cure in three things. There is cure in three things. That is, Babu Shifa'u Fi Salasin. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, healing is in three things: a gulp of honey, cupping, and branding with fire. That is called cauterization. But Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam forbid the followers of him for cauterization. So with this hadith, we can know that 1400 years ago only the uses of these fruit as a medicine were known. The next I want to say is of cumin seeds. Cumin seeds has a constituent known as thymoquinone. It contains a constituent which is known as thymoquinone. This constituent had the effect on viruses. It is actually, this thymoquinone is an antiviral. It decreases the viruses in the spleen and the liver. It decreases the growth of the viruses and also try to kill the viruses in their phagocytosis in spleen and the liver. And hadith is also narrated with the cumin seeds, narrated by Abu Huraira radhiyallahu ta'ala an. Narrated by Abu Huraira radhiyallahu ta'ala an, Sahih Bukhari 5688, book number 76, hadith 11. It says that, I heard Allah's messenger saying, there is healing in black cumin for all diseases except death. That is, fil habatin sawada shifam min kulla da'in ila sam. That there is healing in black cumin for all the diseases except death. So here is the time where we need to pray, and not only we need to maintain the physical cleanness but also the spiritual cleanness. So before ending, I would like to pray to God to prevent us, to protect us all from this pandemic. And I want to say that, I want to read a dua for protecting and to be safe from all this. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Allahumma inni auzubika min al-jununi wal-juzami wal-barazi wa-sayyid saqam. Okay, it means, oh Allah, I seek your refuge from insanity, mutilation, leprosy, and from all serious illness. Jazakallah. Thank you.
Thanks, Zahra. Concept of cosmetics in Yunani system of medicine. Concept of cosmetics in Yunani system of medicines is unwanted.
Yeah, Zahra,
can
you hear me?
Miss Sheikh Tayyaba.
Assalamu alaikum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu, ma'am. Respected chief guest, dignitaries, organizers, and participants, a very good afternoon to all and a very happy Independence Day. I'm Tayyiba from final year, Dr. Abdul Haq Yunani Medical College and Hospital, Karnool. And first of all, I would like to pray the Almighty Allah to bless us with all good health and safety in this pandemic. In this period of corona effect, besides all the treatments, the best solution is having mental stability and mental strength, of course, which we would obtain in all prayers and peaceful life by supporting our families with positive attitude. My today's topic is also some positive things which are available in our daily life to make our skin with a good complexion and active. And my today's topic is about concept of cosmetics in Yunani system of medicine. The term cosmetology is used for the study and application of beauty treatment by using cosmetics of beauty, skin, face, hair, nails, etc. The word cosmetics means any single substance or a compound product intends to local application of external parts of the body for the purpose of beautification. The history of the use of cosmetics spans at least for 7,000 years and is present in almost every society on the earth. And cosmetics body art is argued to have been the earliest form of ritual in human culture. According to the sources, early major development includes the use of Rohane Erend as protective balm, and skin creams include Mom, Rohane Zaitun, and Arke Gulab. Romans firstly invented the concept of makeup and used Kuhal as a line, as an eyeliner.
Yeah.
Concept of Yunani medicine. Healing of the body works on four humors that all we know: Khun, Balgam, Safra, and Sauda. When these humors are in perfect harmony, a person radiates inner and outer beauty. Yunani scholars believe that the presence of toxic materials in our body makes a person look ugly or diseased. The Yunani cosmetics are mainly based on medicinal herbs and partially on mineral and animal sources. And I would like to show some slides about various Yunani herbs as cosmetics. The best Yunani herb, Poshte Santra. Poshte Santra contains vitamin C. It makes your skin look youthful and bright. It makes the skin soft and smooth and firm. Poshte Yusuf. It has a natural property of revitalizing the skin and wrinkles anywhere in the body, adds special glow and helps in nourishing the skin. Elwa, that is none other than aloe vera, adds nutrition to the skin and is the best moisturizing agent. It also helps in hair care, helps in reducing the dandruff and gives silky look to this hair. Haldi. Haldi acts as an antibacterial and antiseptic agent, and it is mainly helpful in improving complexion of the skin. Astral Sus. It acts as a skin whitening agent and helps in adding glow to the skin. Arke Gulab. This is also a very simple and easily available in every house. It is used as a makeup remover also. It is nothing but rose water, acts as toner and helps in giving cooling effect to the skin. It helps in nourishment of the skin and helps in development of glowing skin. Tulsi, it is also easily available in our society. It is used as an anti-aging drug. It reduces the aging effect in our body. Gajar, it is rich in keratin and acts as a toning agent to the skin. Leela, it is mainly used to treat in the treatment of fungal infections, and it acts as an antifungal agent. Gile Multani. Gile Multani is commonly used as a face pack in every house. Every girl likes to have this as a face pack. It effectively absorbs oil, dirt, sweat and impurities. It helps in softening the skin and gives a glow to your skin. Asle Khalis is nothing but honey. Honey, it is using of honey is a sunnah. Honey helps in balancing the bacteria and acts as anti-acne agent. Honey helps spread up your skin cells, healing process. Amba Haldi. This is a very good agent in treatment of acne. This helps in removing acne and helps in the reduction of dark spots. Also helps in gaining the glowing skin. Kafe Darya. It is mainly a jali adviya, which means it is used for cleansing of the skin. It acts as a strong jali and helps in cleansing the skin and is very effective in curing acne. It can be applied as instant face pack to make your skin glowing. Neem. This is also easily available in our society, and it has many effects on our positive effects on our health. Acts as an anti-dandruff agent and helps in reducing hair fall. It is also used broadly in the treatment and is applied in chickenpox to reduce its efficacy. Kalonji. As we all know, Kalonji, maut ke siva har ek bimari ki shifa Kalonji mein hai, and it is very effective in treatment of skin diseases like leucoderma. Bakchi. And this is also a very effective medicine in the treatment of skin. skin diseases. It is mainly used in the treatment of psoriasis and other skin inflammations. Bargehina, and as we all know, using bargehina is also a sunnah. It is used as a natural hair dye, and it helps in conditioning the hair and makes the hair look silky and bright. Amla. Amla is a health tonic and hair tonic. It is rich in vitamin C, acts as a toner, and helps in reducing dandruff. It mainly helps in controlling hair fall. Bhangra. Bhangra helps in... It actually provides nourishment and nutrition to the hair and prevents the premature graying of the hair and makes the hair look voluminous. And I would like to share some of the types of Yunani drugs on the basis of pharmacological actions. Jali Advia. These Advia are mainly used for cleansing the skin. This has a detergent activity used for cleaning the skin. Example, asl, honey, bure armani, phitakri, chaksu, haldi, etc. Khad is advia. These advia are applied locally to increase the tone of the skin. Example, gile multani, gile surkh. Musafiye khun advia, used to remove impurities from blood. For example, neem, charaita, unnab. Musafiye khun advia are very helpful in enhancing the beauty from inside and removing the impurities from the blood. Murakhi advia, these are very effective and soothing. These act soothing effect to the skin and helps in softening the skin. Example, rogane badam, rogane kunjat, mome zarda. Thank you, one and all, for giving me this opportunity. I would like to thank all the chief guest dignitaries and organizers and my teachers, Fazlur Rahman Siddiqui sir, who selected me for this, and Dr. Safaraz Nawaz sir for guiding me in this topic. Thank you, one and all. Jazakallahu khair. Assalamu alaikum.
Thanks, Deva. मैं डॉक्टर हमीद सर साबिका प्रिंसिपल अलारिफ यूनानी मेडिकल कॉलेज की शुक्रगुजार हूँ जिन्होंने अपने बिजी शेड्यूल से कीमती वक्त निकाल कर आज के इस वेबिनार में दिया। मैं सर से अदबत इंतमास करती हूँ कि सर पेश करें।
हेलो
जी अस्सलाम वालेकुम सर
जी सर
प्रिंसिपल साहब का मैं थैंक्स करके अदा करती हूं हेलो
जी अस्सलाम वालेकुम सर, डॉक्टर हमीद सर। What's wrong, Afifa?
Yes, ma'am.
Sir was looking online and again he left. I mean, he left or what? I think some issues are there on
that. Mic off hai, ma'am, sir ka.
Achha. So ask Shoaib to guide him.
Okay, ma'am.
Achha, till then you ask Sarfaraz sir, he's looking online, his professor from Abdul Haq Unani Medical College, Karnool. Yes, Sarfaraz sir. Sir, are you there? Are you here listening to me? Is Dr. Samia, Dr. Samia Shireen?
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam. Sam, you can have some concluding words. Actually, there is some problem with the Hamid sir mic, or I don't know, the network issues are there. You just can have some concluding words for our speakers.
Yeah, definitely. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam.
Jazakallahu khair everyone for joining and attending the webinar. And I would like to thank the organizer and all the, and without any break. And it looks more or less like it's a makeup for missing the classes in the college. And their presentations are very informative and precise. And the time management was very well. I would like to thank everyone on behalf of UMO for joining this, and we would like to see more and more participation of yours. Thank you so much. Assalamu alaikum.
Hello.
Sir.
Wa alaikum salam.
Ji, assalamu alaikum sir.
Hello, assalamu alaikum.
Ji, wa alaikum assalam sir. Hey, sir.
हाँ
सर, आपकी आवाज आ रही है।
हेलो,
आपकी आवाज
आ रही है। बहुत बहुत अस्मा और सामिया शिरीन और तमाम को बहुत बहुत मेरी तरफ से दिली मुबारकबाद। काफी अच्छा प्रोग्राम है, कीप इट अप, और हाविली मुबारकबाद है। बहुत अच्छा मालूमती प्रोग्राम है और आप सबको मेरी तरफ से बहुत बहुत मुबारक, खुसूसन सामिया शिरीन, अस्मा, बहुत अच्छा काम कर रहे हैं आप लोग और बहुत ही मालूमती प्रोग्राम है। कीप इट अप, प्लीज कंटिन्यू इट। जज़ाकअल्लाह खैर, अस्सलाम वालेकुम।
जज़ाकअल्लाह सर, थैंक यू सो मच फॉर जॉइनिंग अस सर, थैंक यू सो मच, इट्स एन मोटिवेशन फॉर अस। अच्छा, डॉक्टर सरफराज सर, डॉक्टर सरफराज नवाज सर फ्रॉम, ही इज एन एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर फ्रॉम अब्दुल हक यूनानी मेडिकल कॉलेज। सर, कैन यू हियर मी?
सबसे पहले तमाम आसमा मैडम और दीगर तमाम ऑर्गेनाइजर्स का मैं तहे दिल से शुक्रिया अदा करता हूँ। रियली इट्स ए वेरी एंकरेजिंग एंड मोटिवेशनल प्रोग्राम। आई थिंक इट्स फर्स्ट ऑफ इट्स काइंड हु कंडक्टेड ए वेबिनार अमंग द स्टूडेंट्स टू एंकरेज देयर करियर एंड टू एंकरेज देयर एफर्ट्स। रियली आई एम वेरी मच happy and I'm very much thankful to the organizers, especially FU for the team, the whole team, and the president of FOUMEA who really think in such a manner to uplift the efforts and caliber of the Unani students. And it's a very good thing that really they have merged all the colleges and they consider all the college students, especially final year students, and the presentation of all the students was very nice, very informative. I'm thankful and I congratulate all the students whoever participated and whoever presented in this webinar. But finally, one thing I want to say that if possible, let the program, let the webinar be conducted in all aspects and in other topic also, as the pandemic is going on. In such scenario or in such situation, by conducting such a program and by encouraging the students, it is really a good task. I once again thankful and congratulate all the participants and presentees, whoever presented in a beautiful manner. And last but not the least, the organizer or the president of FOUMEA, and Asma Madam, thank you so much and for giving me an opportunity to speak among you people. Thanks a lot. Have a nice day.
Thank you, sir. Jazakallah khair. Bahut bahut khushi hui. Actually, just now I spoke to the Siddiqui sir. He said like he's busy somewhere and you can represent on his behalf. Thank you so much for joining, and it's a sort of inspiration for all of us. And in fact, it's just an attempt, sir, to motivate our young speakers. We are already in the market, but we need to, it's a duty on our shoulder to build up the confidence in them. So thank you all. Thanks, Sir Faraz sir. Thanks, Hamid sir. Alhamdulillah, very renowned personalities of our Unani Society. And Dr. Samia Shireen, our host, Mrs. Afifa Wasif, and all our speakers. Alhamdulillah, it's really, I really appreciate the idea which came in my mind to merge all the colleges together, like the Abdul Haq College, relocated students of Al-Arif Unani Medical College, and obviously the hub of Unani, that is Government Nizamia Tibia College. I hope the confidence of the students have been raised, and it's in these students are in fact ideal for all the viewers, for all the those who are on the screen. So I expect all the students to come forward and join the hands with us to build up the Unani system, to raise the Unani system. Thank you once again. Inshallah, we'll come up soon with another webinar next week, in a week or two. Thank you all for giving your precious time and sharing your ideas with us. Thank you, sir. Allah Hafiz. Thanks all the viewers for taking out the time for us. Thank you so much. Allah Hafiz.
Thank you.